Now we're going to take a wee break from the fishing just for a minute. And that's not because we're sick of kingfish, quite the opposite. They are amazing, we want to get more footage of them. And the big story, of course, is under the water. So, I've got the dredge here. And just like it's flapping around there looking all enticing, I reckon they'll chase it. We've got a camera in the back of the dredge and we should get some pretty cool footage.
Right here, close to the rocks, is where we've been catching the kingfish. But they've been holding down deep in 30 metres or more. But we don't have to troll long before the dredge raises a kingfish out of the deep. And once we raise one, a whole bunch of his mates come in to check out this artificial, shimmering shoal of baitfish that the dredge represents. It's hard to make out with the wide-angle GoPro, but these are big kingfish. All of these guys are over 25 kilograms. And here, you can see a kingfish with a bent mouth, probably from an encounter with an angler or a fisherman. But kingfish are very hardy, and despite its deformity, it remains in good condition. The trevally are feeding on tiny krill, and they're less interested in the dredge, but the blue kohiru flock to the dredge, not because they want to attack the baitfish, but because they want to join them. The dredge looks like a panicked shoal of baitfish, and to the kohiru, this is a signal to join the group for safety in numbers. And the dredge looks real enough to even get a bite from this kingfish. Trolling a Rapala behind this dredge would be deadly, but we've still got tired arms from fighting kingfish.